What I realized is that our behavioral styles and the way that we are wired and how we present in the world has a lot to do with what is our relationship with time. So in the end, there's a very small amount of people in this world who actually value time as a currency. The rest of us kind of try to cruise and understand and make some sort of sense of what time is.
So joining me on the line today, I've got Ildi Rass from The Time Fix. Welcome to the call, Ildi.
Thank you, David. It's nice to be here.
It's a pleasure having you here. So maybe tell us a bit about The Time Fix and what The Time Fix actually is.
Well, The Time Fix is, I specialize in helping you find more time when it really counts and when you think that there is none left. So it's all about time management with a twist, because I believe that you can't manage time, you can only manage yourself. And the past almost 6 years, in my experience, first you have to make friends with your time, and first you have to understand what is your relationship with your time before you can even start tackling the big job of becoming more productive.
Yes.
Using time right.
Yeah. Well, it's an interesting problem, because I think most people we meet, or I meet, if I ask them about time, you know, who needs more time in their day, everyone says yes, which technically means that they're not very organized, I guess. And I'm a fan of what you just said. You know, we don't manage time, we manage activity or yourself. And I think a lot of people don't realize the value of their time. Yeah.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And look, what I realized is that our behavioral styles and the way that we are wired and how we present in the world has a lot to do with what is our relationship with time. So in the end, there's a very small amount of people in this world who actually value time as a currency. The rest of us kind of try to cruise and understand and make some sort of sense of what time is.
Yeah. Yeah. I remember Robert Kiyosaki, I think, said it best. He said, poor people will spend time to save money, and wealthy people will spend money to save time.
Spot on.
Yeah. Yeah. So tell me, what made you go into this business?
Oh, the story starts with a divorce. some of these journeys do. And suddenly I had to not just pay for dance classes and all swimming classes and so on. I had to actually support myself and my two beautiful girls. And I had to realize that I'm not as organized as I would like to be. So I'm missing the organized gene, which is a bit of a funny statement from a time management specialist, but it's true. And I created a small business planner because I couldn't find one on the market. So that's how the journey started. And about a year later, once I started to ask all my clients what they do with the planners, some said, yeah, give me the next one. And the other was like, oh, I don't really know. It didn't really work for me. And this is where I realized that just because you have a good tool, it doesn't mean that you know what to do with it. So the consultancy of the business started to grow. And nowadays, I specialize and I work mainly with people and businesses on how to create more time in their busy schedule rather than selling a planner. But using a planner, whether that's an electronic or paper or whatever, is an organic part of what I do, because it is the best way to visualize where your time goes and how do you perceive time in your life.
Right. Okay. So really, like, I suppose driven by necessity, you've worked out how to improve the production or productivity of your time.
Well, and I suppose it's the best business to start from a need.
Yeah. And so now, as a result of that, you now help people in business by using these tools. But you also mentioned that using things like behavioral profiling as part of your time management tools. How does that fit in?
Very early on, I realized that there's different behavioral types will relate to time in a different way. And I guess it comes back to neuroscience. And I do refer to this quite a lot. As much as we have a part of our brain that is responsible to perceive color or to hear and so on, we don't have that for time. So that means that every single one of us, I don't know, 7 billion of us on Earth, will pretty much perceive time in a different manner. So I started to look into what are the common denominators and how can you actually still look at some general traits. Mm-hmm. And I found that behavioral profiling is a great way to start because it will give you a basic understanding of what is your basic relationship with time. And of course, we know that behavior is, no one is just one thing. We all are a mix of different behavioral styles. Yeah. But understanding what are your core drivers when it comes to time is quite important. And as I always say that only the dominant style understands what it means, this sentence, you know, that we use all the time, time is money.
Mm-hmm.
The rest of us know what the sentence means, but we don't necessarily have a relationship with that sentence.
I understand. So let me ask you on a bigger note, obviously you've been studying a lot and you've been learning a lot and analyzing how we can improve the use of our time. What's a book or a podcast or a author that has inspired you in your journey?
Actually, one of the books that changed the way that I look at time is Life in Half a Second.
Yeah.
And it's one of the books written by Matthew Michaljevic. And if you haven't read it, it's a must read book because it will change your whole perception on time and existence on earth and even goal setting, because in the end, the book is about goal setting.
Yes.
But it's just showing, I guess one of the biggest takeaway from that book is that we talk about time and we talk about, you know, doing things later, like we know that there is later. And the reality is that we don't know if there's tomorrow. So how do we waste time now based on an assumption that there's going to be tomorrow?
Tomorrow. Yeah. Interesting. Yeah. It's one of my favorite. We recommend that a lot with our coaching, but you sort of touched on a few things there. And often when I talk to people about time management, the missing component is the goal setting.
Oh, yes.
You can be super productive, but doing the wrong thing. And to me, I say, look, you can be super efficient. You can be really good with time management, but if you don't have a destination, if you don't have a goal or an objective, you're just spinning your wheels. You're running the treadmill. So it's interesting that you brought that book up as a point of reference.
It's a funny thing because one of the things that I always say is that if you don't have your goals in order, it's like jumping in the car and telling the GPS, take me somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much what it's like. Interesting. Look, I'm mindful of time and I just would like to sum everything up. If you had some advice that you would give to someone in business right now, in terms of what's the thing they should focus on or do first, what would it be?
Be present in anything you do.
Mm.
That's probably the first thing. My own personal definition of time wasting is not spending time on this or spending time on something else. It's not being present in what you do. If you sit on the couch and watch a TV show and your mind is somewhere else in business, you're not watching the TV and you're not working on your business. So that's the perfect definition of time waste. No matter what you do, just be present because everything starts with enjoying and making the most of the moment now.
Yeah. Nice way to finish. Perfect. Ildi, thanks so much for your time. Really valuable to get a bit of insight, understanding of what you do and the importance of it. So thank you.
Thank you, David, for having me today.
Pleasure.